Welcome to this video lecture. In this video we will understand linear regression. Let us begin with scatter plots. A scatter plot is a collection of points on a graph, where each point represents the value of two variables, that is, an x-y pair. If we assume that x is the return on the S&P 500 index and y is the return on stock ABC, then graphically the plot will look like this. The degree to which these variables, i.e. return on S&P 500 index, or x, and return on stock ABC, or y, move together is called covariance. Covariance captures the linear relationship between two random variables. Here, a positive covariance implies that the market and the stock tend to move in the same direction, whereas a negative covariance implies that they tend to move in the opposite direction. But covariance has its limitations. It is sensitive to the scale of the variables, and its value is in terms of squared units, which may range from positive to negative infinity, hence making it difficult to compare two covariance values. To overcome these limitations, we calculate the correlation coefficient of these variables, after calculating the covariance. Correlation measures the strength of linear relationship between x and y. It's a pure measure and has no units. Correlation has a range of minus 1 to plus 1. Let us look at the five scatter plots of the stock ABC returns and index returns to understand correlation. Limitation to correlation analysis is that it may be affected by outliers, leading to spurious correlation, and as a result it does not capture strong nonlinear relationships between variables. When one tries to capture a mathematical relationship between x and y variables, by fitting a line, polynomial, or a curve through these scatter plots, such that if one should be able to make a reasonably good prediction of y given x, then the mathematical process of deriving such an equation between x and y is called regression analysis. To break it down further, regression explains the variation in a dependent variable in terms of an independent variable. The dependent variable y is the variable that you want to predict. The independent variable x is the input variable that we use to predict the dependent variable. In our example, the stock ABC's returns are dependent and explained using the market index returns. If we try to fit a line through this scatter plot that best explains the observed values of y in terms of observed values of x, we get a simple linear regression model. Linear regression assumes a linear relationship between the dependent and independent variables. The following regression equation describes that relation, yi equals b0 plus b1 times xi plus ei. This equation states that the dependent variable y is equal to the intercept b0 plus a slope coefficient b1 times the independent variable x plus an error term e. The error term represents the portion of the dependent variable that cannot be explained by the independent variable. We refer to the intercept b0 and slope coefficient b1 as the regression coefficients. All the points on the regression equation line predict the y values for the corresponding x values. However, the optimal regression line is the one for which the sum of the square differences or the vertical distances, or the sum of squared errors, or SSE, between the y values predicted by the regression equation and the actual y values is minimal. Thus, the regression line minimizes the SSE. This is the reason why simple linear regression is also called as ordinary least squares, or OLS, and the estimated, or the predicted, values by the regression equation, that is, y predicted, are called least squares estimates. The slope coefficient b1 of the regression line is calculated as covariance of x and y, divided by the variance of x. And the intercept coefficient is the line's intersection with the y-axis at x equals 0. To understand the coefficients more intuitively, let us consider the returns for stock ABC versus S&P 500 index. The slope coefficient in a regression line is called the stock's beta, as it measures the relative amount of systematic or undiversifiable risk in ABC's returns. If the slope of ABC returns is more than 1, its returns tend to increase or decrease more than the market returns. For a slope or beta of 1, ABC would have the same level of systematic risk as that of the market on an average, and for a slope or beta less than 1, returns increase or decrease lesser than the change in the market returns. The intercept term is the ex post alpha, that is, the measure of excess returns of stock ABC as compared to market index returns. If the intercept term is negative, it means ABC has underperformed S&P on a risk-adjusted basis, and a positive intercept means it has had excess returns on risk-adjusted basis.